happy morning to all my children of class 7 who is watching this biology class, and I am glad to welcome you all in my botany class. In today's botany class, you will be learning the continuation of chapter 1. What is chapter 1? Tissues, right? In our previous class, we have already studied about the explanation part of simple tissues, right? What are the two types of tissues? Simple tissues and complex tissues. So simple tissues, the explanation we had already studied in a previous class. In this class, we will be studying about complex tissues. So what is the topic for today? Complex tissues. So let's get started. The word complex itself says that it is a complicated structure. It is not simple, but it is complicated. How it is complicated? Let's learn. We call it as complicated because it is made up of more than two types of cells. Okay, in simple tissues all, if you see, if it is chlorenchyma, full of chlorenchyma cells you will have, full of green cells you will have. But in this case, it is called complex because it is made up of more than one type of cells. There will be one tissue, but there will be two or three types of cells within the same tissue. Okay, these two or three are of different types, no? Then how can you put them all into one group and call it as one type of tissue? Because all these two or three types of cells will be doing the same function. That's why it is all put together. Okay, so complex tissues itself mean there are more than two types of cells. They all work together as one unit. Though their structure may differ, though their shape may differ, they will do the same function. That's why they are all put together in one place. What are tissues? Group of cells together. If I collect many cells and put it together, I can call it as a tissue. So in these complex tissues, there will be two or three types of cells, but they will be located in the same place and they will do the same function. Since they are located in the same place, they can be called as one unit. If you see the structure, it will appear like one structure, but inside, if you see, there will be two or three types of cells in the case of complex tissues. Okay, so they work together as one unit, and two or more kinds of cells they will have. There are two types of complex tissues. Okay, we are repeatedly talking about complex tissues, no? In a plant, there are two main complex tissues. One is called as xylem and the other is called as phloem. So what are the two types of complex tissues? Xylem and phloem. If you remember the chart what we studied, the types of tissues, I gave a chart in the previous class, I guess. So in that chart itself, I have mentioned that complex tissues include xylem and phloem. Do you remember? So about the structure of this xylem and phloem in detail, we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, actually what these two are doing in a plant, what is its role in a plant, what is its function in a plant? Just remember, if you hear this word xylem, always remember the word water. If you hear this word xylem, just remember the word water. These concepts, know about xylem and phloem, until your university level, you will be repeatedly studying at various levels. Even in your higher secondary, in 11th and 12th all, again you will study about xylem and phloem. So the basics of xylem and phloem, what you have to remember always is xylem means water. If you hear this word xylem, just recall the word water, and if you hear the word phloem, recall the word food. Okay, xylem, water, phloem, food. What is it, how it is connected with the food and water? See, in plants, certain materials are transported, right? What is transportation? Actually, you have to use the word conducted, which means it is transported. So you pour water in the ground, right? The roots absorb the water. Who carries it to all the parts of the plant? If you have a plant, you have roots all, no? So suppose if you pour water here, okay, the roots will absorb water. Who will take to the upper parts of the plant? It has to be distributed in every part of the plant. Now, who takes it? These two only take them. Okay, xylem and phloem only take them. This xylem, I told you, if you hear the word xylem, just remember water, because xylem is the one which takes the water to all parts of the plant. What did I tell you? Xylem takes water to all the parts of the plant. So if you hear the word xylem, always remember the word water. If you hear the word phloem, always remember the word food. Okay, what phloem does? Phloem is the part of the plant which will carry the food from the leaves to all parts of the plant. Why do I tell the word leaf? Do we add food? Are you providing food for the plant daily? You make food and provide them. Even if you provide, it is called as minerals. It is not called as food. Plant itself synthesizes its own food by a process called as photosynthesis, right? Plants prepare their own food. Where photosynthesis happens? Photosynthesis happens in the leaf. Okay, so from the leaf, all other parts of the plant has to be provided food, no? So who takes the food? Phloem takes the food. Remember, like this, phloem, F. It sounds like F, no? F for food. The other one, xylem, is water. Like that you can, remember. Okay, so what did I tell you? When you pour water, xylem is the one which will take the water and distribute the water to all the parts of the plants. Similarly, phloem will take the food from the leaves and give it to other parts of the plant. Okay, so this is about xylem and phloem. Now, this xylem and phloem together is called by the term vascular bundles. Xylem and phloem together has a term called as vascular bundles. Separately, I call them as xylem and phloem, no? Together, put together and if I have to give them a name, I can call it by the name called as vascular bundles. So what is vascular bundles? Vascular bundles is equal to xylem plus phloem. So xylem and phloem together are called as vascular bundles, or else they can be called as vascular tissues. So xylem and phloem together are called as vascular bundles or vascular tissues. So what have we studied in this slide? Complex tissues are some tissues which are made up of two or more than two types of cells. Okay, so what do they do? Though they are of two, three types, they all work together as one unit or one structure. And then complex tissues include two parts. One is called as xylem, the other one is called as phloem. Xylem always carries water, phloem always carries food. And xylem and phloem together is called by the term vascular bundles or vascular tissues. Okay, so now in detail we'll study about xylem and phloem. Okay, before that, where are xylem and phloem present? Where can you find them? I'm repeatedly talking about xylem is present in plant, phloem is present in plant. No, where all can you find them in plant? They are present in three parts: the roots, the stem, and the leaves. Where all can you find xylem and phloem? The roots, the stem, and the leaves have xylem and phloem. First, we'll study about the structure of xylem. So this is the structure of xylem. Okay, I told you if there is a complex tissue, it will be made up of two or more types of cells. Now, see here, you can find yellow color type of cells and blue color types of cells. So there are two types of cells in this xylem. That's why it is called the complex tissues. See, the structure is different. The structure is different, right? That's why it is called as complex tissues. So what are the properties of xylem? Xylem are always dead. When can you call? Do you have dead materials inside a plant? Yes, you have. Dead cells are present inside the plant. Why do you call them dead? It is inside a living. Plants are living, right? Then how can you call them dead? When you call something as dead cells, when there is no protoplasm. There is no protoplasm. What is this protoplasm? Protoplasm is equal to nucleus plus cytoplasm. Protoplasm is equal to nucleus plus cytoplasm. So if these two are absent in a cell, then you tell that protoplasm is absent in the cell. Okay, so these xylem do not have nucleus, do not have cytoplasm. That's why we tell that xylem is dead, because it has no protoplasm. What is the next property of xylem? So xylem is a network of elongated tubes. What is a network? What is internet? When do you use this word net? Net means more than one thing is connected, right? So here also there are many elongated. What is elongated? Elongation means it will be this way, like a long tubes it will be. Okay, so elongated tubes. So here xylem has elongated tubes. See these structures, there are long tubes, no? That's why it is called as elongated tubes, and it is a network because all these tubes are connected to each other. So first you have seen xylem is dead. Second you have seen it is made up of elongated tubes which is in the form of a network. What is the next property? They are arranged end to end. End to end means there is no space in between. They are packed side by side to each other. They are arranged end to end without any space. In like a row, they will be arranged continuously. Then the next property is they have thick cell walls. See, the cell walls are all very thick in nature. Okay, and these cell walls, generally all plant cell walls are made up of cellulose. Okay, plant cell walls are made up of a substance called as cellulose. But in xylem alone, in a plant, you will have lignin. So instead of cellulose, what do you have here? Lignin is present. So they have thick cell walls, and it is made up of lignin. So this is a special property of xylem. These two are unique characters, that is they have dead cells and they have lignin instead of cellulose. So what is the next property? Yeah, they have pits in their walls. What is pit? Pit means like a hole. Can you see many holes are present? Can you see holes? These are all holes, no? Pits means holes. Why do some structure in a plant need holes? I told you, what is the function of xylem? Xylem should transport the water, no? So through where it will take? It will take through the tube-like structures, and there are holes so that the water will be distributed to other parts. Okay, so every part water is distributed through these pits or holes. Okay, so what have we studied? They are made up of, xylem is made up of dead cells. It is a network of elongated tubes arranged end to end side by side, and they have thick cell walls made up of lignin but not cellulose, and they have many holes in their structure. Okay, so this is all about the structure of xylem. Next we'll see the detailed structure about this yellow color region. Also you're going to study about this blue color region. Also you'll be studying in the next slide. So the elements of xylem. Okay, the elements of xylem, I told you this yellow color portion is one element, this blue color portion is another element. This yellow color portion is called as tracheid, and the blue color region is called as vessels. So what are the two, what are elements? Elements means it consists of, xylem is made up of this and this, that's all. Element is not something very great. Elements means what it is made up of. It is made up of two structures called as tracheids and vessels. Okay, so I told you tracheids is this yellow color region. To differentiate tracheids from vessel elements, before that you should know a term called as end walls. What is end walls? See, if you have a tube like structure, you will have certain divisions or partitions in them, and these are called as end walls. What are they? End walls. So in both the structures, see, you have end walls. Where is the end wall in tracheid? You have here, right? Here you have end walls. And in the case of vessels where you have, here you have end walls. So both of them have end walls, but the shape of the end walls vary. Can you notice how is the shape of end walls in tracheids? It is tapered. What is tapered? Tapering or tapered means narrow. It is narrowing like this somewhere, right? So like this, a narrow structure you have here. But in the case of vessels, the end walls are not tapering. They are end to end to each other, and every unit in these vessels, no, this is the blue color is the vessel, right? So every unit is called as vessel element. It is called as vessel element. So let's see the display. See, in tracheids, which is a tracheid, in tracheids you have end walls tapering. What did I tell? Which is the end wall? This is end wall. It is tapering. It is not straight. It is narrowed at some place. It is tapering. Here the end walls break vessel elements. So end walls is the one which partitions each vessel. Breaks means it is not breaking or it is not damaged all. It means it is the one which divides or partition each vessel element. Which is a vessel element? This is one vessel element, this is one vessel element, and this is one vessel element. So the end walls in the vessels are the ones which should break the vessel elements. They are connected end to end. I told you, no, if something is packed next to next, you can call it as end to end. See here, each element, vessel element, is packed end to end. So this is all about the elements of xylem. Next we'll study about a special type of xylem called as secondary xylem. So what is that secondary xylem? Let's learn in the next slide. Secondary xylem is nothing but wood. Okay, see, in plants, all the plants will not have wood, right? Only some plants will have wood in them. Why so? If there is secondary xylem, there is wood. Okay, see here, wood, if you see, there will be an outer region in the wood. It is called as bark. Which region? Sometimes, no, if you stand near a tree also, if you are a naughty child, you will be trying to peel out that bark, no? The one which can be peeled out is called the bark. See, that is the bark. Okay, that is not wood, that is the bark which can be removed easily. So inside the bark you will have a thick structure which you cannot break, right? Only the carpenter can break that, or with the axe only you have to break that. So the one which can be peeled is called as bark, that is not called as wood. But the wood, what inside the bark you have something, no, that is called as wood. See, this region is the wood. This wood is technically called as secondary xylem. What is it called? It is called as secondary xylem. Secondary xylem is nothing but wood. Okay, so from where you get wood? From where do you get wood? In some plants there is a part called as cork cambium. What is it? Cork cambium. So if the cork cambium divides, what did I tell you? In some plants there is something called as cork cambium. If the wherever in which plant all the cork cambium divides, it will give rise to secondary xylem, that is called as wood. Can you understand? What did I tell you? In some plants there is a substance called as cork cambium, and if this cork cambium divides, it leads to the formation of wood or secondary xylem. Okay, so sometimes the wood is soft in nature, as in the case of coniferous trees, and sometimes the wood is very hard in nature, as in the case of angiosperms. What are angiosperms? Angiosperms are flowering plants, right? So this is all about secondary xylem or wood. So next what we have to study is about the structure of phloem. So before learning about the structure of phloem, let's quickly learn about the functions of xylem. I told you even in the introduction part, what is the function of xylem? It is to conduct water. What is the function of xylem? Always it conducts water. It conducts water, and along with the water it also carries minerals. If the minerals are dissolved in water, it will also carry the minerals. See here, this blue color region shows that xylem takes in water. What is the, you can see blue arrow mark, right? I will use some other color so that you can easily see. So see here, can you see this, the blue color ones? This is the flow of water through xylem. Okay, the blue arrow mark shows flow of water through xylem. So it carries water in this way. And then how it carries? From where to where? From the roots to all the parts of the plant. From roots to all parts of the plant. Then how is the direction? Direction is always upward. So can you see downward arrow in blue? No, right? It flows only in this way. It will not flow this way. Only upwards it can carry. Then it also, xylem's one more function is it also gives mechanical strength. The presence of xylem will make the plant stand erect and makes it strong. So what are the functions of xylem? They carry water. Along with the water, they also carry minerals. Sometimes they give mechanical strength, and always the way they carry is in the upward direction. So this is about the function of xylem. So next we'll learn about the structure of phloem. So see, this is the structure of phloem. So what all you need to know about phloem, the properties of phloem, you'll see one by one. First, they are living cells. So xylem, I told you, they are dead cells which will not have protoplasm. Here they are living cells, so they have protoplasm. What is the next property? They are elongated tubes. Just like the xylem, phloem is also elongated tubes. It is a long tube like structure. Then what is the next property? It is arranged end to end. So next to it, you will have one more phloem. Just like the xylem, phloem is also arranged end to end like a continuous arrangement without any space. They are arranged. So they are arranged end to end. Then they are thin cell walls with cellulose. I told you all cell walls of plant is made up of cellulose, no? Just like all other parts, this phloem is also made up of cellulose. The only exception is xylem is made up of lignin, but phloem is made up of cellulose. So these are the basic properties of phloem. What all we have studied? Phloem are living cells. Since they are living, they have protoplasm in them. And then like the xylem, they are also elongated tubes arranged end to end. Next, again you will have one more xylem here. Like this, it will continue. And then the cell wall is made up of a substance called as cellulose. So this is the structure of phloem. Like the xylem, you also have elements of phloem. Elements of phloem means what all is there in the phloem. There are two parts. One is called companion cell. See here, can you see some bulky region here? Can you see a bulging like this? This is the companion cell. This is the companion cell. So xylem is made up of two parts, companion cells. I'll display the slide first. Okay, companion cells and sieve tubes. So I told you this bulky region is companion cells. Where are the sieve tubes? You have one central portion, no? So this central region is called sieve tubes. Okay, I'll mark in two colors. So yellow color is companion cell, blue color is sieve tubes. So what are the two elements of phloem? Companion cells and sieve tubes. Just like in the case of xylem, no, you saw that there were vessel elements. Each partition was called as vessel element, no? Similarly, this is called, the sieve tube has also elements, and they are called as sieve tube elements. What are sieve tube elements? This is one sieve tube element. This is one sieve tube element. So each rack like structure is called as one element, one sieve tube element. This is the whole sieve tube, and each partition is called as sieve tube element. And also you have something called as sieve blade. See, can you see a round structure which has holes? Can you see? This hole is called as sieve. See, in your home, if you have seen your mother when grinding rice or flour, all, no, she uses sieve, no, sieve to take in the, collect the fine particles of flour. She, your mom should be using this, right? So that is a sieve, and you, what you find there, there are small small holes in them, no? Similarly, here also you have a plate like structure which is called as sieve tube plate. So this round structure is called sieve tube plate, and the holes are called as sieves. Okay, through this only, what is the function of phloem? I told you phloem will carry the food, right? So phloem carries food through these holes. Okay, so I'll display the explanation part. So sieve tubes will have sieve tube elements. Which is sieve tube element? Each part is called one. This is one sieve tube element and sieve tube element. And then sieve tube plates are present. Which is the sieve tube plate? This one is the sieve tube plate. This is also a sieve tube plate. What do they have? They have sieve or pores which can carry the food. About companion cells, you will be learning in your higher grades. Just I will tell you, companion cells will support in the transport of food, will support the sieve tubes. Sieve tubes is the one which will mainly carry the food, but companion cells, companion means a good friend, right? So they always accompany the sieve tube. They are always present next to the sieve tube and they help in the transport. So this is all about the elements of phloem. Next we learn about the functions of phloem. What are the functions of phloem? I told you already, phloem always carry food, right? See, in this picture you can see orange color aroma. Can you see orange color? So where all it goes? It goes to the fruit, it goes to the flower, it goes to the I'll mark with yellow color. I'll mark the direction of phloem. So from the leaf only it goes. Why? Leaf is the place which will make food, right? So from the leaves it goes to the potato to store food, it goes to the flower, it goes to the fruit. See, it fruit is also a storage food, right? You have food in the fruit. So it is in both directions. So what is the function of phloem? It conducts, what all it conducts? It conducts food. Phloem always conducts food. From where to where? From the leaves to the stem or the roots. From the leaves. Why from the leaves? Because leaf is the place where food is produced, right? So that food is conducted to the root. Say for example, if potato or any other tuberous plants are produced, for them the leaf will supply the food that is in the form of potato. So food is made in the leaf and given to the stem or the root. In some cases roots are modified as a food material. In that case it will give to the roots. Or some fruits are directly present in the branches itself. So in the leaf they make the food and give it to the fruit. In leaf they make the food and give it to the stem, that is underground stem. In leaf they make the food and give it to the root, like carrot. All they can make in the leaf and provide to the root. See, in the case of this, the direction in xylem we saw always water flow upwards, right? Do you remember? But in this case in phloem, there is it is bidirectional, which means it can move either upwards, it can also move downwards. If it is going to supply, if the leaf is going to supply to the fruit, it will, the direction is upward movement. If the leaf is going to supply to the stem, underground stem, the direction is downwards. So they can move in both the directions. See, they have both upward and downward moments. So the functions of phloem are, they can conduct food and from the leaves to the stem or the roots they supply, and the movement is always upward and downward in both the directions. So this is all about the functions of phloem. They conduct food. Okay, the homework part. So today's homework is going to be a activity. Okay, so what you're going to do is, you take some glass tumbler or a big glass bowl or something. If you have, you can take a glass, because you can see the color clearly. So you can take a glass tumbler or a glass bowl. Okay, so in that you cut a small stem, any small stem which is not so thick. Don't take a stick all, wooden stick all. If you take, you cannot see the results. Okay, so maybe coriander leaves you can try, like that soft stemmed plants you can take. Okay, which should be, the stem should be almost white in color, then only you can see the color. Okay, don't take like woody plants all, please don't take, you will not get the result. So any soft stem you cut, and here in the glass tumbler what you have to do is, you have to mix any dye. If you have a thick paint all, no, for coloring you will have, no, you can mix that paint in water, or if you have food color also, that's well and good, you can use food color. You need not go and buy all, whatever you have, whatever color you have in home, you can use. Okay, even if you have ink, no, you can use ink also, diluted in water. Okay, one thing is, do not make it so dilute. The color should be thick like this, then only you will get the result. So make a dye solution, put the stem inside. Okay, so now we have studied in this lesson that xylem and phloem conducts water. They take water from down to the up. So that you are going to prove in this experiment. So after 5 or 6 hours, keep like that itself. After 5 or 6 hours, what will happen? You can see colors in the stem and the leaves. Okay, so what will happen after 5-6 hours? You can see colors in the upward region, like in the stem and the leaves. What does this teach you? You can prove that the plant has taken up, the stem has taken up the water you have supplied. Already stem will have water, right? You call it as a cell sap. Okay, but now from the color, what you can prove? That the plant has taken up the water what you provided. Do you understand? So you can do this and send the picture to me. Okay, so in the last class, Darren has given me the first right answer, and the answers for the previous homework is these one, 2 to 5, I have given in page number 18. No, you can copy this, you check with your answers. If it is wrong, please correct now itself. Okay, in page number 18, questions 2 to 5, this is answers for previous homework. So today's homework, I gave you a activity, right? So activity you can finish and send the picture to me in this number. Okay, those have got good results, I'll display the picture in my next class. So that is all for today's botany class, and until I meet you in your next class, you all take care and bye bye.